Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I rise in opposition to this proposal. However, I do want to commend the Republican caucus that has been supportive of this on one particular issue. On page 7 of the amendment that was added to the bill, lines 17 through 22, they say the Commonwealth experienced a revenue deficit of over $1 billion in the general fund revenue collections for fiscal year 2016-17. And two, the Commonwealth's general fund continues, and I repeat, continues to experience a structural deficit where annual expenditures exceed recurring revenue collections. Now, heretofore, only the Senate Republicans, the Senate Democrats, the governor, and the House Democrats have acknowledged that there actually is such a thing as a structural deficit. At least in this document, we finally have House Republicans acknowledging that there is a structural deficit and that it has been ongoing. I commend you for that. However, what you're proposing continues that structural deficit. In addition to the devastating cuts that have been outlined by many members, this proposal has insufficient funds to balance out next year. Several members on the other side have pointed out that, you know, families use their savings. But they don't use their savings that are already committed. When they get their paycheck and deposit it, they don't go, look, I've got a big fund balance. I'm going to go on vacation. They say, oh, but there's a big fund balance today, but tomorrow I've got to pay the mortgage, and then I've got to pay a car payment next week, and then we've got to buy food, and then we've got to do other things. And so they don't spend that entire fund balance. What we've heard here is that there are $630 million being taken from special funds that are already committed to programs and projects throughout the state. And we're going to take it and spend it on something else. Additionally, the transfer that is used from the tobacco settlement fund means that $350 million coming into that fund for the next 10 years won't exist. So we haven't balanced anything. What we've done is said, let's take $650 million that would go out from the special funds next year. Let's take $350 million that would go out from the tobacco settlement fund, and let's spend it on the general fund. Well, that's $1 billion that's not going out so that we can put another $1 billion out. It doesn't solve any problem. It's still $1 billion shy. And next year, that $350 million for the tobacco settlement fund is not going to be there. And the $100 million extra that you're paying because you got your credit downgraded, it's going to be another $100 million that's not there. So you've dug yourself a $500 million additional structural deficit every year. Mr. Speaker, this is like taking a payday loan. We've had discussions about this in the House. If you can't pay your bills, it's not a good idea to go take a payday loan because you won't be able to pay them plus the heavy interest that you're paying on a payday loan. That's what we're doing here. It's a payday loan. The best description that you can give to this proposal would be to paraphrase that great American philosopher Wimpy, who said, I'd gladly pay you Tuesday for a billion hamburgers today. That's what this is. Only the cartoon's not that funny anymore. There is an impending credit downgrade. And this proposal is not going to be accepted by either the Senate and or the governor. We will default on payments on Friday and again on Monday. And as somebody said, once they come back and repossess your house and repossess your car, it doesn't matter if a week later you say, I have the payment. They don't give you your car back. They don't give you your house back. Mr. Speaker, this is folly.